It's going on, everybody. Welcome to Quick Brick Games, where we cover everything LEGO gaming. And in this video, we're going to be talking about LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga. And we're going to be breaking down the Gamescom trailer that we got at the end of August, a couple months ago now. And I never really did a breakdown of it here on the channel. You know, we kind of covered all the information surrounding it and all the information that we got out of it. But now we're actually going to break down pretty much scene by scene. We're going to go through almost every little thing that's shown here and kind of break it down and look at what details we can find throughout the trailer. And yeah, let's go ahead and get started here on this breakdown of the trailer. So we're just going to watch it through, and we're going to stop it several times to kind of look at what's going on in each scene. So let's go ahead and begin. So starting off, we have the ESRB logo, of course. And so there we see the two sons of Tatooine. And boom, right here we have our first shot at Luke Skywalker in the game. And you can see him with the next-gen graphics. I'm assuming this is like PC or maybe a next-gen version of the game. You can see the new Luke Skywalker Episode 4 Tatooine model. He's got the shaggy hairstyle, which he didn't have in the original Complete Saga game. And yeah, there's not much else to say here, but yeah, he's looking really good. Alright, so here we have a shot of Luke once again, but this time on Dagobah. So let's go ahead and freeze it here. And so you can see he's like, you know, trying to do a handstand using the Force. He's got some stuff floating around him. He's got R2-D2 floating back there, and it's actually like a muddy version of R2-D2. So according to TT Games, I think the new game engine that this game is shipping with is going to have some dynamic effects on the character. So like if your character is walking through sand, the sand will actually like dynamically get on your LEGO minifigure character. So I think that's going on. I think that's what's going on with R2-D2 here, is as you're playing this level in Dagobah, similar to the first game where you had R2-D2 and Luke Skywalker, I think R2-D2 this time is going to get like mud on him dynamically, which is pretty cool. But anyway, so here you can see some like pictures floating around Luke. So we got like a nice little picture of Han, Tatooine Luke, and Leia there on the left. And then on the right looks like a picture of Bespin, which is where he's going to be going to face Vader. That's kind of what he's training for. And there's also like, it looks like a little triangle in front of him. You can't see the other side of that, what that has on it, but I'm sure it's some other joke. Then of course on the right you have Yoda there, his new model, but let's go ahead and continue on. Alright, so this next scene is the classic Vader versus Luke scene from Episode 5. And wow, this looks great. So you can see the new lightsabers. This is the first time we've seen lightsabers in this game, pretty much. So this is going to be a fun duel. The animation looks a little bit stiff here. I'm not sure if it's done or not. Probably not. This game's like several months out at this point still. But yeah, this is going to be a fun duel. And we'll actually get to see a little bit of the gameplay of what lightsaber duels look like in this game. And they look pretty cool. But other than that, there's not too much to say here other than this is the Luke versus Vader fight from Episode 5. Alright, so here we have the classic pod racing scene. So now the trailer kind of goes through the episodes, sort of, like Episode 1 all the way up to 9. And so this is the pod racing scene from Episode 1, and this was a kind of notorious level from the Complete Saga in the original LEGO Star Wars game. But in the background you can see some other characters, some other pod racers, some creatures, Jawas, things like that. But here we have a shot of what Qui-Gon Jinn looks like in this game, and you also have what Anakin boy version looks like. He's got a kind of a shaggier hairstyle similar to what Luke's looked like in the previous scene. But yeah, let's go and continue on this trailer. Alright, so he puts on his helmet, and here we actually get to see a little snippet of what the pod racing level, or the gameplay of the pod racing level, is going to look like. And man, it is a lot different. So like through the normal gameplay of this new game, things are going to be in third person, which is a big change. But here you can actually see they changed it to first person for this pod racing section, which is interesting. So I'm not sure if the whole level is going to be first person like this. Maybe this was just a shot from the trailer, but I think this looks like gameplay. Like on the left, you can see what looks like a, sort of like a canyon that looks destructible. It looks like it's built out of Legos there on the left. So I'm guessing you can just run into that. You can see sort of what looks like another pod racer in front, but other than that, you can't see too much here. But yeah, this definitely seems to be a drastic change from what we got in the Complete Saga with the old third-person perspective. Now we're getting a first-person perspective on this level, which is interesting because all the other vehicle level gameplay that we've seen from this game is third-person, so kind of interesting how they went first-person for this level. Possibly it could just be for the trailer again, but I guess we'll have to wait and see when the game comes out. Alright, let's continue on. So there we have our first shot of Anakin kind of as an adult or teenager from Episode 2. So this is on Naboo. This looks like it might be from the open world gameplay. I'm not totally sure. Anakin kind of has a different, it almost looks like his hair is like slicked back, which that's not like what his hair looked like in the movie. This is the only kind of new minifigure model I'm not too sure about. Like, just the hair just seems like it's off. Like, it doesn't look like his hair from the movie. I would almost prefer how it looked like in the original game, where it was just kind of like a generic Lego minifigure hairstyle. But there you can see his blue lightsaber. He's got his cape on. They're bringing back the capes to kind of represent the Jedi robes. And this looks like what's going to be the open world of Naboo. So very cool there. You can see the water looks really shiny in the background. Looks very nice. So let's continue on. Alright, so moving on, here we have a quick shot of Geonosis. So we saw Anakin on Naboo, now we're seeing him on Geonosis. This is during the big battle of Geonosis, and wow, this level looks a lot different. So it looks like those pillars there in the middle are all climbable, and this is actually the second time TT Games is remaking this level. We had it in the original game. Actually, I guess if you they had it in the original LEGO Star Wars game, then they remade it again, sort of, for the complete saga. Then they remade it again for LEGO Star Wars 3, and now they're remaking it again. So this level has been remade multiple times by TT Games, but this definitely seems to be the biggest change. In the background, you can see some other Jedi characters. Looks like Luminera in, on the right there, and looks like maybe Aayla Secura, I believe her name is, down there on the left middle, sort of. You can see the new battle droids that look great. I like their color. They look a lot more accurate. And yeah, this is the Battle of Geonosis area, and you can also see in that clip Anakin using like a force push, which was a lot different than how it was in the old games. Like in the old games, you would have like this blue icon around a character, then you would press the force button, which was usually like the B or circle button, depending on what console you're playing on, then you could use the force on it. But right there in that clip, we didn't see any like glow around the characters. Like, he's just straight up used the force push and it just blew everyone away. Like, we've never been able to use the force on multiple enemies before, at least I don't think so. So definitely seems to be a new feature there of just being able to force push multiple enemies right out of your way. Alright, so here we have Mustafar. So we saw Obi-Wan there riding on that little droid, just like in the movie. And this is the scene, like this is the level I want to play the most from this game. And so Anakin's eyes, I think, look a little bit weird. I said, you know, episode 2, Anakin's hair looks weird. I think episode 3's Anakin's eyes look a little weird. Like, I guess this is just what he's going to look like when he's evil during this Mustafar fight. I don't know, they just kind of stick out. Like, I'd almost prefer if they were just like the normal, you know, black Lego eyes, I guess. But yeah, this is some of the lightsaber dueling gameplay. The camera's real zoomed in right behind your character. You're playing as Obi-Wan. I'm not sure if player 2 is going to be Anakin, like in the original game, or if you're going to be playing as somebody else. I would imagine it would still be Anakin, but I'm not really sure. But this looks like it's towards the end of the fight when Anakin gets wrecked. But let's go ahead and continue on. And so there is our first shot of Emperor Palpatine in this game, or Darth Sidious. His hood has a different model to it. I think this is like a more modern LEGO minifigure hood that we've seen in the more recent LEGO sets. And it's kind of a funny scene. You have the stormtroopers, or the, I guess they're clone troopers, but they're, I guess they're newly stormtroopers, like using fishing poles to pull all burnt up Anakin like out of the lava, which is kind of a funny joke. So I like that. But yeah, there we have Palpatine himself in the trailer. Alright, so yeah, there we go. They're pulling him out. There we have Anakin becoming Darth Vader, and this is a really cool shot. This is from episode 4. I saw a few people online, you know, back when this trailer first came out a while back, speculating that this could be Rogue One footage. This is not from Rogue One. I've actually got confirmation from a dev at TT Games that this is from episode 4, from the beginning of the movie. So there you go. There's Darth Vader. Looks very good. Very shiny helmet. I like his red lightsaber. I like the red glow going everywhere. Very cool shot from the trailer and the game. Alright, so here we have a really funny scene from episode 4 and towards the beginning when Luke gets the message from Leia from R2-D2. And the background's kind of funny because you have like C-3PO like taking a bath or something. Like, you can see the little, the hat on his head, whatever you call those things, and like the brush in his hand. I don't know what's going on there, but very bizarre. And like, Luke looks like he's taking a nap or something. This definitely looks like they're turning it into a big comedy scene. So there we have the message from Leia being played, and here we go. This is actually a cool gameplay clip. I like these third-person shooting segments. These look really cool. You can almost see what looks like cover there, like on the left and the right. It looks like you're going to be getting behind cover, so perhaps the whole cover shooting sections from LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens from 2016, those could actually be coming back in this game based on this image. But it's hard to say because a lot of the shooting sections just look like those old cover shooting sections in this game, just because everything's third person, so it's hard to say. There we see a scout trooper like shining a laser, and you can see the laser like pointing on the back of Luke's head. So I'm not sure if there's a way to dodge that, or if you're just supposed to shoot it before you know, it you get hit. I'm not sure. That door in the background looks like it's covered in gold LEGO objects, so in previous LEGO games. Like, I know the LEGO Marvel games, you would use, like, Iron Man's laser to destroy those. So I'm not sure what's going to destroy the gold LEGO objects in this game. I think in the Force Awakens game, you had to get, like, a group of like, stormtroopers or clone troopers or something to help you destroy those. So I'm not sure if it's going to be the same thing here. There's also, like, the LEGO duck there on top of the cover. But yeah, this looks like it's going to be the return of cover shooting sections. But man, it looks really good. Let's continue on. All right, so in the very next scene here, we have the X-Wing scene from the ending of episode 4 when Luke Skywalker's in the X-Wing and he goes to destroy the Death Star and blows it up. And Darth Vader's, like, chasing behind him. We actually had this exact same third-person scene in the original LEGO Star Wars 2 game and the complete saga. But here it looks way better. Like, look at the sides of the Death Star. Like, you can see every little knob on the Death Star. It's crazy, the amount of detail here. Looks like there's, like, destructible objects and things. It looks crazy. Really good-looking scene here. And so there we go. He destroys that turret. And here we actually have a cool shot from Dagobah. We already saw Dagobah a little bit earlier on in the trailer. But here we have Luke using the Force to pull up the X-Wing. And of course, he's, like, unable to do it, and he has to have Yoda's help. But one thing I did notice here is you see Luke's lightsaber, like, on, like, holstered on to his left side there. So that's very interesting. So in the previous games, like, when you would put your lightsaber away, it would just kind of, like, disappear into your character. Like, they would kind of put it to their side, but it would just disappear. So here it looks like when you put away your lightsaber, it actually physically stays on your minifigure. I hope that's the case with all the characters. That's a pretty cool feature. The lightsaber handles don't look to be unique. I think they're all generic. I think they were unique in the Force Awakens game, but I think they're just going back to, like, generic looking lightsaber hilts, which is, you know, some people may think that's a bad thing. Let me know what you guys think of it in the comments, but yeah, this is a cool scene from Dagobah. Alright, so here we have a shot of Endor from episode 6. This is actually an exact remake, it looks like, of the level which was called Speeder Showdown from LEGO Star Wars 2 and the complete saga. And this doesn't look too different. So in that game, the camera was obviously zoomed a lot more out. Here, it's the more third-person perspective, and they pretty much keep that throughout the whole game, except that pod racing level, which we saw earlier. But here, you're chasing some stormtroopers, some scout troopers, and you're shooting them on the speeder. So I'm not sure if this is going to work like the original game, where they try to get behind you to shoot you, then you have to kind of, like, do a loop to slow down and get behind them. I'm not sure if the gameplay is going to work very similar to that. But yeah, this is a cool shot of Endor from episode 6. Alright, so there we have a shot of Ghost Obi-Wan, which was pretty cool. But here I want to freeze for this scene with Han Solo and Luke and some of the skiff guards, because this is obviously from episode 6 as well, earlier on in the movie from Tatooine, when he's going to rescue Han from Jabba the Hutt. And so there we have the first look at what Han Solo looks like in the game in his skiff outfit when he's, like, blind after he gets unfrozen from carbonite. And we have the skiff guards on the right, which we've seen before. We got Lando in the background, and then we have Luke, Jedi Luke, drinking some blue milk. And they seem to use that joke a lot. The deluxe edition of the game comes with a minifigure with blue milk Luke, so it's definitely a funny joke. All right, so there we go. He gets a nice blue milk mustache. So we have a shot of Leia from the sequels, like, changing out her hair to the new style. Then we have a shot of Rey. And here you think it's going to be old Luke, but no, it's a bunch of porgs. And so here's the first shot of old Luke. We saw him at the end of the Force Awakens game. It was kind of weird how he wasn't playable in LEGO Force Awakens. I have no idea. Like, he should have been, like, one of the last characters you unlock or something like that. Like, maybe a reward for getting 100%. But anyway, he's definitely going to be playable in this game, that's for sure. And you can see his long hairstyle. I don't know if I've ever seen that LEGO hairstyle before, so it's definitely interesting there, and that's a cool little joke with the porgs, but let's go on and continue on. And so there he's, like, trying to take his robes back, and here we go. This is probably one of my favorite scenes from the whole sequel trilogy. This is the throne room fight after Snoke gets killed, and so this is a pretty cool shot. Like, the lightsabers are really bright, and you got the guards there that you're going to take out, so I'm really interested to see how this level plays out. I imagine one person is going to be playing as Rey, and then if you're playing two-player, another player is going to be playing as Kylo, and you're just going to kind of lightsaber duel these guys. So it should be a pretty fun, dynamic scene, and I'm definitely excited to play this one for sure. And there we have a shot of Poe and BB-8, and here is another cool scene I wanted to pause on, and this is Finn going down this zip line. And man, you can really see how big the environments are going to be here. Taking advantage of the new LEGO game engine. I'm guessing it allows them to create bigger environments, because this is insane. Like, you can look in the background. So you've got on the right side a tree that has fire on it. So typically when you see fire, LEGO fire like that, you can put it out in some way. I'm not sure if that's going to be the case here. In the background to the right of that tree, just slightly, you can see a blue object that looks to be some sort of collectible. It's definitely not a mini kit, but I'm not sure what that is. You can also see some other playable areas down below Finn and to the left of the mountainside, and even in the background you can see some climbable cliffs. So yeah, all of this is playable, which is insane. So I'm not sure if this is going to be the hub world or not, but yeah, this is definitely interesting from episode 9. So you can see there's Rey from episode 9 going on Kef Burr about to fight Kylo, and here is the actual Kylo fight. So I wanted to pause here. So this is Rey versus Kylo Ren. And what I really wanted to point out here is BB-8 in the background, the far right there. So I'm not sure how lightsabers are working, lightsaber battles are working with two players yet, because I don't think you're just going to be playing as whoever you're lightsaber dueling all the time. That might be the case for the Mustafar fight with Obi-Wan and Anakin, but I don't think that's going to be the case all the time. So perhaps the second player is going to be BB-8 in the background. Because we actually see something similar with the Obi-Wan versus Darth Maul fight. I'll be talking more about that later, but that is interesting. So here they're duking it out. Lots of cool animations there. She does a massive force jump over the water. There's a shot from the ending of episode 5. There's Anakin and Padme. And I wanted to freeze here. This is where you see old Lando. This is the first time we see him. And his outfit looks like it's straight from the Solo, A Star Wars Story movie, which I guess is how it looked like in the movie. He's got the big collar, and then we see the new character, Janna, I believe her name is, in the back left there behind Chewbacca. We see a Porg in the middle, and yeah, you can. There's just so much detail in this game, man. Like, the minifigures are just insanely detailed now. There's Chewbacca. Okay, let's go and continue on. So there we go, he pushes the Porg out of the way. Here we have our first shot of the yellow lightsaber. There's some Jawas that just ran out of the way after she turned it on, or the gold lightsaber. Do people call it yellow or gold? I guess I'll call it yellow for now. But yeah, it looks great. This is like a shot from the very ending of the whole Skywalker saga. This is probably the last cutscene in the game. So yeah, cool shot. I'm not sure how this is going to work. Like, if there's going to be two different versions of Rey, like a blue lightsaber Rey or a yellow lightsaber Rey, or if you're actually going to be able to customize her lightsaber and just change out that part. I'm not sure. Guess we'll find out later on. And then we have a closer up shot of that. And then we have Bespin from the ending of episode 5, Millennium Falcon. And so here we have a cool shot. Let's freeze on this of, the snow speeder on Hoth taking out a AT-AT. This is a very cool shot. It looks very sharp, and you can see the snow build up on the snow speeder, and I'm guessing you're just going to wrap around the AT-AT just like the movie. And yeah, this looks great. I'm excited to play this level. I like the third person perspective. I didn't really care for this level in the original games, but I like the way it looks now, at least, so we'll have to see if they improved upon it. So here we have a shot of episode 3. This is Obi-Wan versus General Grievous. This is the fight that we all wanted to see. So we see a bunch of AI in the background there, a bunch of stormtroopers, or clone troopers I should say, and droids. And apparently I think those clone trooper models are incorrect. I think they're from episode 2. But I think TT Games already acknowledged on Twitter that those are incorrect and that's going to be fixed, so don't worry about that. And there are some things that may be incorrect with the lore, but there's of course plenty of time for them to fix it. This game got delayed till next year. You know, assuming the game's coming out in March or April, they still have, you know, several months, like half a year to fix any issues you might see with this game. So I wouldn't worry too much about that. But yeah, again, the camera angle looks very similar to before. Those things on the ceiling on the left and right, you know how in the movie he force pulled those things down onto the droids. I suspect those are going to be involved in the gameplay. Maybe you have to pull those down on Grievous or something like that. I guess we'll have to wait and see. It's hard to say right now this early on. But yeah, very cool shot. Here we have a shot of the Rancor from episode 6 from the beginning of the movie. This looks a lot different than it did in the first game. You actually see a gold stud on the bottom right there to the right of the Rancor. And I'm guessing you're going to have to find a way to cause the door to crush the Rancor just like the movie and how it worked in the first game. But yeah, very cool. Look at the Rancor there. He looks much bigger than he did in the Force Awakens game. And so here we have another shot of what looks like the open world. This is some Mace Windu Coruscant gameplay. I think this is the open world. I don't think this is within an actual level. And yeah, it looks great. Like, oh man, just exploring these environments is going to be crazy. Like, they look huge. The third person's perspective definitely changes things up. And you can see a bunch of AI. I imagine those AI are going to have side missions and things for us to do. And yeah, this is just a cool look of Coruscant. Hopefully we can go like under the Jedi Temple. That would be cool. But let's go and continue on. And so here we have a shot from episode 8. This is Finn and Rose Tico riding that AT-ST, kind of destroying everything. This is after they fight Captain Phasma. And it's a pretty cool shot. Other than that, I don't have too much to say about it. But yeah, very cool look at Finn and Rose in a galaxy far, far away. And here we have another space battle section here. And this is actually a cool scene. I wanted to pause here. This is Millennium Falcon taking out some Star Destroyers. And man, look how detailed those Star Destroyers look. Like, it's insane. Look at the TIE Fighter on the left. Like, you can see every little LEGO accurate LEGO brick there as well. The detail of this game is insane. I can't wait to play these levels. This possibly could be from the open world, because we know there's going to be open world on all the planets throughout the movies, but there's also going to be this open world space environment. I'm not sure if it's all connected or not. This could be from the open world, not from an actual level, because we know there's going to be like random space battles you can get involved with. So, very interesting look here. And there we have a look at Han Solo from Episode 5. And Chewbacca. The animation there looks a little bit choppy. I'm not sure if it's designed to look like that or not. Okay, hang on, we gotta pause here. This is a look at Obi-Wan Kenobi and Darth Maul fighting from Episode 1. And there was actually another clip. I can't post it here because it was like on Instagram or something, and it would be difficult to find, but I'm sure some of you guys have seen it. But there was a post on Instagram that actually showed a different looking shot of this scene, and you could see like a health bar on the top. They're ditching the whole heart things, like, you know, and typically in LEGO games you have four hearts. Whereas in this game, based on that Instagram video that the official Star Wars account posted, Darth Maul had like an actual like green health bar. And behind Darth Maul was like Qui-Gon Jinn. You don't see Qui-Gon Jinn at all here. I'm not sure if they edited him out. But I think in the final level, Qui-Gon Jinn's going to be like behind Darth Maul. And that's who your player 2 is going to be. And he was like meditating, I think, in that clip. So yeah, your player 2 is not going to be Darth Maul. It's going to be Qui-Gon. So, like I was saying before, it looks like your player 2 is going to be kind of doing something in the background as you're doing your lightsaber duel, similar to what we saw on Kef Burr with Rey and Kylo Ren fighting. We saw BB-8 in the background. I imagine your player 2 is going to be that BB-8, and here your player 2 is going to be Qui-Gon Jinn. So, very cool look here. This obviously looks way more like the movie than the game ever did. In this scene in the game, you were like fighting a bunch of droids. You weren't even fighting Darth Maul, so I'm glad they're ditching the droids and letting us fight Darth Maul here. So here we have a cool shot of Episode 9. This is the ending of the movie. This is like right before or right after Darth Sidious does that like ridiculous amount of lightning into the sky and destroys like all the ships. Like, it's just a ridiculous scene. But here we have what looks like Finn, I think it is, or Jonna, I think it's Finn, riding one of those like horse creatures. I'm sure you guys know what those are called in the comments. And so this looks like maybe it's an on-rail section where you can't control where you're going, you're just kind of going forward and steering. If you look in the right there, in the middle, you can actually see a minikit. So this is what minikits look like in this game. We've seen this in the official screenshots from the game. You can check out my screenshots video where I analyze all those. But that is definitely a minikit on the right, so you're going to have to steer right so you don't miss it. It's one of those things where if you miss it, you have to replay the whole level. Always hated those, but it looks like they're going to be bringing that back in the Skywalker Saga game. And there we have confirmation of Yaddle is playable. We already knew this from an interview with TT Games, but it's cool to see here for sure. And I did want to point out, this looks like it's on Kashyyyk, and this looks like it's from the open world of Kashyyyk, because I doubt Yaddle is actually playable during the story mode. I'm sure she's just a free play character. But yeah, very cool to see her here in Kashyyyk open world gameplay. And here we have Tatooine. This looks again like the open world environment here on Mos Eisley Spaceport. And you can see C-3PO riding a vehicle or a bantha there. So before, C-3PO and protocol droids couldn't ride vehicles like this. And now it looks like they can, which is interesting. And on the right, you can see what looks like a climbable wall. So yeah, this definitely looks like it's going to be open world content. And this is the last shot I wanted to freeze on. So this is Princess Leia from Episode 5. It looks like Lando is there on the bottom left. And she's shooting at the Slave 1, Boba Fett's ship there. And it looks very cool. You see her Imperial logo there on the bottom right. And yeah, this looks like a really cool scene. You see like a look on the bottom of the screen there towards kind of the middle right. You can see this some random Lego minifigure legs that have just got blown off, I'm assuming. And it looks like the Millennium Falcon's on the right as well. All right, that's pretty much all I wanted to freeze on, so we'll go and continue this. There's the Battle of Crait. We got Han and Greedo. We got the Battle of Geonosis, some destruction going on. And here we have this final scene between Luke and Palpatine from the ending of Episode 6 when they have their battle. And it's kind of a joke scene where he pulls out his like fake lightning, and he's like, oh wait, I need my real lightning, and then he pulls that out. And that pretty much ends off the trailer, so we can't really say too much about that scene. But yeah, that's pretty much gonna do it for this breakdown video. If I missed anything, please let me know in the comments. Let me know what you thought of all the stuff I did point out, and if you didn't see it. And like this video if you enjoyed it, dislike it if not, and be sure to subscribe, be notified when all the newest LEGO gaming content comes out here on the channel. I'll see you guys next time here on QuickBurt Games.